greet you all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Everyone in the house of the Lord.
Ngiyamukela wonke umuntu othe ukuza endlini yenkosi.
Open Genesis 37 verse 2.
Sizovula amaBhayibheli ethu ku Genesis.
These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years old, was feeding the flock of his brethren, and the lad was with the sons of Bilhah and the sons of Zilpah, his father's wives, and Joseph brought unto his father in their evil report. I ask you, Larry, to open the word of prayer.
So, Kotam Samakanda, Zvala Meshlo, Standards. Siyakubonga Thixo, siyakubonga Ngcwele, siyakubonga Simakade, siyakubonga Nkulunkulu, siyakubonga Mdali wezulu nomhlaba, silapha sibuthene ebukhoneni bakho ukubana sizokuzwa ilizwi lakho, njengoba watsho ukubana umuntu akaye kuphila ngesinkwa kuphela kodwa nangelizwi linye ngalinye liphuma emlonyeni wakho, singasihlephunela Nkosi yami Nkulunkulu Somandla, isabelo sethu namhlanje, Nkulunkulu Somandla siyakhuleka, sibika nokubeka, Nkosi yami umtshumayeli kwezakho izandla, umsebenzise belicaco lakho Nkosi yami engaye kukhuluma ulwazi lakhe kumbe intando yakhe, kodwa intando yakho Nkulunkulu Somandla sithi mayenziwe phakathi nakwe. Sinezindingo, sinezicelo Nkosi yami ezehlukeneyo, kodwa siyazi ukubana wena lokho ngomunye izolo namhlanje kuze kube phakade, nakakela omnye nomnye wethu Nkosi yami njengokukhangelela kanye nokukholwa kwethu ngegama engcwele lika Jesu Kristu siyakhuleka ngokubonga. Amen and amen.
God bless you. You may be seated.
Singahlala phansi.
Enjoy the song service and the little piece for the little girl.
Sibonga le ndatshana esiphiwe ngintombi encane.
There's a notice all the youth to remain behind after the service.
Goodness, memezelo bonke abasha ontanga belinde ekupheleni kwalinkonzo.
And another notice that all of us to go to the revival after the service.
Goodness, sinyisimemezelo kanjalo kubana wonke umuntu enelisa ukubana ehambe kumvuselelwe khona namhlanje emahatshula.
Emahatshula north.
Nyakatho emahatshula.
By the playgrounds there.
And
after the railway line.
Ngaphambi kwesporo.
So we'll be having the revival just after the service. Those who can, let's go there.
Sizokuba nemvuselelo endaweni yasemahatshula north. Abayenelisayo sitholakale sikhona.
Then the revival in Rose Camp, we had not met Safi booking, so it was pushed to this week, starting on Wednesday.
Imvuselelo yase Rose Camp sibe singayinisanga ukuyihlela kahle kodwa izoqala ngolwesithathu, ngolwesine, langolwesihlanu.
It's definite. I forget again the place that they say it is called. Blue Lamp.
But indawo yakhona bathi iBlue Lamp.
Rose Camp. So Friday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
Ngolwesithathu, ngolwesine kanye ngolwesihlanu.
The revival in South Africa will be Saturday.
Imvuselelo yase South Africa izokuba khona ngomgqibelo
Sunday in Yeovil.
Eberia ngesonto endaweni yase Yeovil.
Saturday is Beria, Sunday is Yeovil.
Ngomgqibelo kuse Beria ngesonto kuse Yeovil.
Welcome all the new people among us.
Samgela bonke abacha phakathi na kwethu la.
One name that is Sister Hazel Namburo.
Silo Sister Hazel Namburo.
Stand as we greet her.
Si enga phakama ngezinyawo simbingelela.
Bless you, Sister Hazel. Right. We have a teaching message today.
Sizokuba nenkonzo yokufundisa ke namhlanje.
So I won't take much of your time. We are about
angikumoshi isikhathi sesiyaqeda.
Right. So where we read the Bible?
Esifunde khona eBhayibhelini.
Joseph was 17 years old when we start seeing his account of
Joseph
his life. So from 17 years there we start seeing in his life. We see God starting to operate in his life. Number 17 is a very interesting number in the Bible.
In number yeshumi nasikhombisa kuyi number eqhakathekileyo eBhayibhelini.
This being 2017 is also a precious year.
Njengoba sikumnyaka ka 2017 kungumnyaka oligugu.
It's a number of system change.
Kusho ukuguquka kwezinto.
We see in the 17th month the ark landed in May.
Kunyanga yeshumi nasikhombisa umtshokotsho wesivumelwano wafika.
In Genesis 17 the name of Abraham was changed.
Ku Genesis 17 igama lika Abraham lashintshwa.
Now in Revelation 2 verse 17.
Kusambulo 2 indima 17.
We are given a new name also.
See, Piwi Kamelisha kanjalo.
In Matthew 17.
Gumateo 17.
That was a transfiguration.
Gwaba inkuku.
And those whose names were changed, Peter, James, James and John.
Abana makama shintwayo uPetro uJohane noJames.
Transfiguration them.
Baba nenguquko ke lapho.
Even in the negative in Revelation 17.
Na kulokho kuphambukileyo kufunyana kusambulo sahloko 17.
How can Rome change this system to papal Rome?
IRoma yesiyedeni ishintsha isuba yisiRoma yokubuswa ngabo papa.
We see even when the prophet was baptizing the 17th person.
Siyabona nomprophet ebaptiza umuntu wesikhombisa.
And said as John the Baptist was
saying, "Yomlilo yehlela yathi njengoba uJohane weza ukwandulela ukuza kukaJesu Kristu."
The second coming of Christ.
Inkonzo yakho izokwandulela ukuza kwesibili kukaJesu Kristu.
The account of Joseph starts becoming clearer when he's 17 years old.
Indaba yempilo kaJosepha iba sobala eneminyaka eshumi nasikhombisa.
We know that his father was in Egypt for 17 years before he
died.
Siyazi
bana uyise wakhe wayeseJipito kweminyaka eshumi nasikhombisa engakafi.
Now there are four major foundations in the patriarch side of the story.
Kunezisekelo ezine kulaba basendulo kulindaba.
Now Abraham is faith.
UAbraham utsho ukholo.
Isaac is love.
UIsaka utsho uthando.
Jacob is grace.
UJakobe utsho umusa.
Joseph is perfection.
UJosepha usho ukuphelela.
See, Jacob was grace because he had a lot of mistakes, but God covered them.
UJakobe wayenamaphutha amanenge kodwa uNkulunkulu wenelisa ukwasula.
But Joseph was perfection.
UJosepha usho ukuphelela.
You can almost find no fault in his life.
Awuboni naphutha nasempilweni yakhe.
Except what the prophet says, that a little scratch was allowed in the life of Joseph so that he is not as perfect as Christ.
Ngaphandle ukubana ebe nje lokubo kuncinyane ukubana engayi kuphelele fane noChrist.
He only gave one lie in his life when he says, "Don't say you are shepherds." It's a
abomination in Egypt.
That's the only plot which we read of in the life of Joseph.
Ilona ichata empilweni yakhe sifunda ngalo uJosepha.
On the gentile side, we are built on the foundation of the apostles.
Sina njengabezizwe siyakhwe kusisekelo
abaprofeti
nabaprofeti nabapostoli.
Kristu
eyilitshe elinhloko.
His name is Savior, salvation.
UJosepha igama lakhe lisho umsindisi.
There is power in a name.
Kuna mandla egameni.
If the wrong name, you just change it.
Kana unezitara kaipa, unori change.
A wrong influence.
Rino kuparun zero ya kaipa.
So when we say four foundations, number four in the Bible is a number
of redemption
and warfare.
Inombolo yesine isho ukhlengwa.
That's why you see four living creatures.
Iko uboni zinanakazana ezine.
This has the four writers in Revelation.
Zilisana na mahachi ayisikhombisa kuncwadi yesambulo.
The four giants in the book of Samuel there.
Iziqoka ezine encwadini ka
warriors that overcame them.
Namakawe amane angobayo.
The four insects, power and keka, locust and caterpillar.
Izibungule ezine.
That were also countered by the power of God.
Ezangqotshwa ngamandla kaNkulunkulu.
The four angels holding the four winds of the earth.
Ingilozi ezine ezibamba amagumba amane alomhlaba.
The book of Ruth, being a book of redemption, in Ruth is just four letters and
it
has four chapters. Ruth
inesahluko ezine.
Ruth deciding.
Ruth ethathuketho.
Ruth serving.
Ruth ekhonza.
Rewarded.
Urute ethola imvuza, urute ebusiswa.
We see the deliverance, the fourth man in the fire.
Siyabona nakunkululeko kuba nendoda eyine emlilweni.
And when he came walking on the water to deliver them, it was in the fourth watch of the night.
Lapho ehamba emanzini ukubana ebakhulule kwakuyisikhathi sesine santambama.
So the redemption story runs
indaba yokuhlengwa
in those fours in terms of
iphakathina kwelinombolo
ine
nokubuyiselwa kanye nosindiso.
Now the life of Joseph was parallel. The life of Christ. Now a life that is lived, a sermon that is lived is better than a sermon that is preached. The whole sermon of David, his life was a sermon.
Impilo yakhe kwakuyintshumayelo.
He was loved by his father but hated by his brothers.
Wayethandwa
kuyise
ezondwa ngabafo bakhe kufana noKristu.
UKristu
wayethandwa kuyise wakhe ezondwa ngabeJuda.
Joseph was spiritually he dreamt
UJosepha
saw visions.
Wayenamaphupho kamoya ebona
nembono. Christ was seeing
kanye noKristu.
Visions of God were spiritual.
Wayebona umbono kaNkulunkulu engumuntu kamoya.
They hatched many plots to kill Joseph.
Bayenza amaqinga amanenge ukubana bembulale uJosepha.
That applies also with Christ.
Okufana kanye noKristu.
They attempted to kill Joseph by casting him in a pit.
Bazama ukumphosela egodini ukubana bembulale uJosepha.
Even Christ in Luke 4:29 they
UKristu kanye
kuLuke
4:29 baza mukubana bemfuqe eqaqeni.
So Joseph went to Egypt.
Joseph why Egypta?
Even Christ went to Egypt in the time of persecution.
Why Egypta?
And Joseph was sold for 20 pieces of silver.
Joseph wathengisa kwendibilishi ezishumi nambili.
Christ was sold for 30 pieces of silver.
Christ wathengisa kwendibilishi ezishumi nantathu.
Joseph was put in prison under false accusation.
Joseph wabeka entolongweni bembeka icala lamanga.
Christ was put in prison under false accusation.
No Christ kanjalo bambeka entolongweni ngecala lamanga.
Joseph suffered with two people, the baker and the butler.
One was set, one was lost, died.
Christ suffered with two people at the cross.
One who was saved,
one was lost. When Joseph was exalted, he went to the right hand of Pharaoh. And when Christ was exalted, he sat in the right hand of God. And now Joseph was Israel's son.
Joseph angari mwana wa Israeli.
Even Christ naturally was an Israelite.
Na Kristu angari mu Israeli.
When they took the vesture of Joseph, they dipped it in blood.
Bachitora nguo ya Joseph avachi nyudza muropa.
Even Christ in Revelation 19, his vesture was dipped in blood.
Na Kristu muna zvakazarurwa chapter 19 nguo yake yakanyudzwa muropa.
Joseph interpreted the inmates' dreams and their future.
UJosepha wahumusha amaphupho naphambilini.
Even Christ preached to souls in prison.
No Kristu washumayiza imphefumulo esentolongweni.
Joseph was 30 years when he was commissioned governor over Egypt.
UJosepha wayeneminyaka eshumi nantathu engumbusi eJibhita.
Even David was 30 years when he began to reign.
No David wayeneminyaka eshumi nantathu eqala ukubusa.
Christ started at 30 years.
Inkonzo kaKristu yaqala neminyaka endishumi nantathu.
Joseph was a shepherd.
UJosepha wayengumelusi.
Christ is the shepherd of our souls. Spiritual shepherd.
Umalusi wemphefumulo yethu
kamoya. So the life of Joseph was a live sermon, a preaching sermon.
Impilo ka Josepha yayishumayela.
He had an excellent spirit.
Why no moya opheleleyo?
Wherever he went, he prospered.
Lapha siyakhona wayephumelela.
If you put him in prison, he prospers there.
Umfake entolongweni wayephumelela lapho.
In Potiphar's house, he prospers there.
Umbeke endlini ka Potiphar wayephumelela.
So a child of God is that excellent spirit.
Mwana wa Mwari ane mweya
wakadaro. Whatever you touch with him must prosper.
Zvese zvaunobata zvinobudirira.
He was directed by the supernatural.
Akatungamirirwa nesimbara Mwari.
But you see, every gifted person,
munhu wese ane
With his spiritual dreams and visions, it sparked adversity. But the adversity could not cancel the predestinated. Because when destiny calls, brother, what God has called you to be,
there
is nothing that can oppose that. The advantages that he had, the disadvantages that he had became his advantages. Whatever they did against him was propelling forward to the fulfillment of his visions. So whatever you pass through, it fulfills your purpose in your life. Because character is not a gift. It's a victory you must overcome. For you to step into your adoption as a child of God, you must pass through the wall of critics before you get to the wall of fame. God depicted the evil conspiracies around him.
Meaning that
everything that is planned around against you, God will defeat every weapon that is formed against you. The more he had adversities, it revealed the hidden power in him. His gift started shining brighter. The more it was opposed. You see, God works even in dreams. In every little gift that he gives us,
if it is
surrendered to him, it destroys the enemies. You see, when Joseph would sleep, when his mental faculties are off, the spiritual faculties were on. When you close your natural eyes, the spiritual eyes are open. When you silence your natural senses, your spiritual senses, the sixth sense opens up. That's why when you fast and this body is down, your spiritual body is up. You see, when the hands of men rose against Joseph, the hands of God rose against hands of men. So it was hands of men versus hand of God. If there is something of God in you, you don't have to fight for it. It will fight for you. Joseph was not fighting for his dreams. His dreams fought for him. He was a courageous man. He didn't care whether people believe it or not. He told them what God has told him. It was so hard even for the father and mother. When they heard that their sheaves will bow before the sheave of Joseph, but he said it as it is. The father believed it, but he pretended to rebuke him before the brothers. There was something about the life of Joseph. His future reign was foretold. Like the future reign of Christ is foretold. He was sent of his father. Like Christ was sent of his father. He has a distinctive vestment. What he was wearing, even Christ had a distinctive vestment. He was insulted and stripped like Christ was. Judah negotiated the selling price of Joseph. That was his brother. Even Judas Iscariot negotiated the selling price of Christ.
Not Judas Iscariot.
His blood was presented to the Father like Christ spiritually. He was tempted but sinned not like Christ. He made no defense when he was accused in Genesis 39. Like Christ did not make any defense. He suffered though innocent. Like Christ. He won respect of his jailer. Like Christ, even the jailer. He had a new name given to him in Genesis 41. Like Christ comes with a new name in Revelation
19.
He dispensed the natural bread for people to live. Like Christ gives the spiritual bread for us to live. His brethren were driven out of their own land because of the famine. Even Christ, the Jews, after they rejected him, they were driven out of the promised land. His own did not know him. When he was speaking to them at one point, Christ came to his known and his own
they did not know him.
He forgave his brethren
like
Christ did forgave his brethren. Now, we're in the darkest hour of Joseph's life, that's when the spiritual shined bright.
But
when human abilities end, that's when the divine hand is seen in your life. There came a payback time where God paid back all the toils of the road.
But
when you suffer affliction with the children of God, you just soldier all the same. One day there will be payback time.
Oh,
what he went through, it was the strategizing God, mapping the way to the throne. His father gave him a coat of many colors. That's right. You wash a robe without a seam represented the Holy Ghost that covered his being. And today the Holy Ghost covers the church as the robe of many colors, the rainbow colors of his beauty. So the church is a robe of many colors. Through also the gifts of the Spirit, you give you your old tattered garment and you get a robe of pure white.
Samba to simhlophe.
The life of Joseph was moving on to a climax every time.
Impilo ka Joseph ayilokhu iqhakamisa
phezulu. Every Christian moves higher and higher.
Wonke umKristu yabelokhu eqonge
eqonga. Towards the climax of the change of our bodies.
Ekufikeni neqongeni kokuguqulwa kwemzimba yethu.
And also his temptations were moving from level to level.
Izilingo zakhe zazilokhu zanda siba zinenge nezigulu.
When he went to Potiphar's house, it was another temptation.
Esiya endlini ka Potiphar. Kwakunge sinye isilingo.
He was the firstborn of Rachel.
Why lizibulo lika Rachel?
Christ is the firstborn from the dead.
UKristu nguyena izibulo kwabafileyo.
Because the womb of Rachel was dead.
Ngoba isisu sika Rachel sasifile.
And he was the firstborn from Rachel.
Waba lizibulo elisuka ku Rachel.
The name of Joseph means savior.
Igama lokuthi Joseph alisho umsindisi.
The name Jesus means savior.
Ukuthi Jesu kusho ukuthi umsindisi.
Joseph's brothers shared Pharaoh's favor because of Joseph, not because of themselves. We share God's favor because of Christ, not ourselves. Now the Spirit of God was in Joseph, says Genesis 1:38. The Spirit of God was in Christ. You see these children of barren women, they were not just simple children, they were very high. Now Sarah gave birth to Isaac, who was a
very
Rachel, Joseph,
Rachel,
Hannah,
Joseph,
the prophet Samuel.
Prophet
it
Samuel.
Means the devil had already sensed that a great person is coming.
Satan
tried to shut it by barrenness and God opened their womb. Now Reuben wanted to rescue Joseph. And Pilate wanted to rescue Christ. Let the world see Jesus in you. Everything Joseph put his hand to do prospered. Even Christ, everything that he did,
it
prospered. Now the life of Joseph, all these great men passed through great adversity, through many dangers, toils and snares. All things were laid to Joseph's trust. Like all things are in the hands of Christ. Now, no man could come to Pharaoh except through Joseph. No man can come to God except through Christ. If it wasn't for Joseph, the whole world would have died of famine. If it wasn't for Christ, the whole world would have died of sin. When Joseph was rejected by his own, he married a Gentile bride. When Christ was rejected by the Jews, he married a Gentile bride, which we are part of. Joseph spoke to his brethren through an interpreter. But then came a time when Joseph could no longer hide himself. He revealed himself to his brethren. So there is coming a time when Christ will reveal himself to the Jews that go back to the Gentiles. After the Gentile dispensation, the brothers who came back during the time of world famine, they went back during the time of world famine. Going back to Egypt, they went to during the time of world famine. When they saw Joseph. Now the Jews went back to their homeland during the time of the world war, after the world war. When Joseph revealed himself to his brethren in Genesis
25,
he caused the wife to go to the palace. When Christ is revealing himself to the Jews, the bride will go to the marriage supper, to the palace in heaven. When Joseph would leave the palace, the trumpet sounded and every knee would bow. When Christ shall leave heaven coming to earth, every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus is Lord. When Joseph's sons were blessed by Jacob, he crossed his hand and blessed the blessing of the elder went to the younger.
So,
through the cross of Christ, the blessing of the children went to us, the Gentiles. There rose a new king in Egypt that knew not Joseph after the death of Joseph and put Egypt into tribulation.
So
they will rise a world leader that does not know the freedom of religion and the Holy Gospel, and from the World Council of Churches, tribulation will start. God planned the sufferings of Joseph in advance to save men. Zechariah 12 verse 10 says, they shall look upon me whom they have pierced, and they shall mourn. And Joseph's brother later repented for what they did to him.
So
that's what we see in Zechariah 12 there. Joseph was likened unto a sheaf.
Because
the other sheaves, they bowed before his. And Christ is the sheaf wave in Leviticus 23, wave before us as an
example.
So the name of Joseph that he was given, the new name, is
Zephpaneh,
savior of the world,
or
bread of life. When Christ was given a new name, Revelation 3 verse 12,
we are also given
a new name. Joseph's brethren fulfilled his predictions without realizing it. The Jews, when they crucified Christ, they fulfilled his prophecies without recognizing
it.
Joseph celebrates their repentance with meal together with them.
When
they sat in their proper places, representing the marriage supper of the Lamb. You see, the Bible is an interesting book. It's not a book written by men. You see, nothing could stop the power of his spiritual dreams. Though they were resisted in his home, that resistance could not stop the spiritual element in Joseph. When the brothers hated him, that could not stop the spiritual element in Joseph. Even when they planned against him, it could not quench the spiritual powers in him.
So,
in the pit and out of the pit, he held his revelation. Even in the hardest times of your life, hold to God's unchanging hands. Even in the hands of Midianites, you are still true to God. Even when the Potiphar's wife lied, Joseph remained true to God. Even in prison, he remained true to God. Brother, whatever you pass through in your life, hold this message, brother. It is going to keep you. He says, because you have kept the word of my patience, I will keep you in the hour of temptation that shall come to try all those that dwell on the earth. You see, if you are going to go to a certain height, you must pay the price, brother, by a life of sacrifice. If you are going to sit at the throne as David, you must meet your Goliath somewhere. If you are going to overcome like Hannah, you must overcome your Penina. If you are going to be thrown to be an overcomer like Mordecai, God will allow a Haman around you. So rejoice in whatever has been allowed around you.
That's what will
propel you to your victory. Father, when Joseph, when his brothers appeared before him, there came a time when he could no longer refer in himself. He cried before his brothers. Initially, he was speaking through an interpreter. Then a time came when he saw his brothers.
It
just touched him.
That
he knew that what he believed one day will happen. It was a long stretch of negative happenings. Genesis dreams and visions. Maybe he had written things at the backside of his Bible. In his notebook that God said, one day this will happen. God said, one day I'll be a ruler. But there was a chapter that was allowed by God, which was negative after negative. But one day the very eyes of Joseph saw the fulfillment of the things that he believed, that one day they will happen. The long dry patch, brother, did not silence the vision of Joseph. One day he saw the brothers doing what he had seen spiritually happening.
But
one day what you wrote about your life, there'll be a payback time, brother. That anointing that made you right will make it happen. That anointing that was renewed at the altar, when you say this will happen in my life, that same anointing will come upon you. It will bring the pieces together against all odds, against all opposition. The power of God will bring to pass what you have believed in your life. Brother, overnight, in one day, he moved, brother, from the prison to the throne. That's what God can do right now. Your life can change, right? After seeing heartaches and heartbreaks and hard times, imprisonment, the chains could not chain his vision. But when you have a destiny, there are not enough devils to stop your destiny. Even your background cannot stop your destiny. Maybe there is a Joseph today who is opening a chapter of fulfillment, rising to your O2P condition. But when Joseph was up there, he was ruling all those who lied against him. He was ruling all those who sold him. He was ruling even the cruel prisoners who ruled, who were afflicting him.
Brother,
that's when God turns the tables of your life. When that divine hand, brother, sees your faithfulness and he says, my child has been faithful. What should be done for my child? There is that crowning moment in the life of a believer. There is that crowning moment where God remembers you, and the toils of the road, they seem nothing. Brother, imagine from the pit, he was once humiliated when the robe of many colors was changed by the robe of prison garments. But then when he moved from the prison garments, he went to royal garments.
Brother,
your garments of sin, your garments of adultery and lust, give him your old tattered garments and get the garment of the Holy Spirit. Put on the garment of praise. the spirit of heaviness will flee away. The garment of diseases must be removed, brother. There is a royal garment for the children of God. When Lazarus came from that grave, the bandages of smelling grave garments were removed and was given a garment of the resurrection.
But
the garment of this body shall be changed, and we shall put on incorruption. Father God can change your picture just overnight. He can change your life just overnight, from poverty to riches, from being a beggar. Father God can change you. I believe that's what He's doing now. Overnight. There was no explanation naturally to what happened. Your victory is not hinging on men's calculations. It's not dependent on your abilities. It's not dependent on the economy. It's not dependent on your success and your O levels and A levels. It's not dependent on what you have done good. It's not based on your righteousness. It's based on predestination. If God foresaw you, brother, being an overcomer, there are not enough challenges in your life that can erase what is in the mind of God.
Brother,
by this I know, the economy of Zimbabwe cannot silence our declarations. We are overcomers. We are more than able. There are no enough giants to stand against us. Even the demons that fight your families cannot stand against it.
When
God stands from His throne and says, I'm now visiting my son. He has toiled long enough. He has prayed long enough. It's payback time. The issue you are praying about, I believe the cup is full in heaven. Like God came to Cornelius and says, Cornelius, Cornelius,
Cornelius, Cornelius,
your prayers have come for a memorial before God. There was a time when Cornelius was praying and God was silent. There was a time when Cornelius was giving and God was silent. There was a time when Cornelius was fasting and God was silent. But when the watch went to the spot where God wanted, God came down and called him by name. He went to his very house, and I believe angels are taking your address. Father, the God who created your eyes, He sees what you are passing through. The God who created your hands, He can touch where you are. The God who created your ears, and hear your Christ. There comes a payback time where the pit you shall forget, where those who lie against you shall bless them. There comes a time, brother, where your online prayer meetings pay you, where your hallelujahs pay you. At that time, brother, all devils cannot touch you. It's adoption time. We have not received the spirit of bondage. Joseph,
when
he was in bondage, he had no spirit of bondage. He had the spirit of adoption. Though you are suffering, you don't have the spirit of poverty.
Now
you have had times, you don't have the spirit of death. So whatever was against what is in the mind of God must be silenced. Brother, from the pit to the throne, God is speaking to someone. Of him.
Maziso,
listen, brother, even if your pastor is not seeing and understanding you, God sees what you are passing through. And when God looks at you, brother, in God's eyes, you are not a poor person. In God's eyes, you are not sick. In God's eyes, brother, you have already met it. Because those that he foreknew, he also predestinated. That he predestinated, he also glorified. In God's eyes, you are already glorified. Things are not like in your eyes. It's what God says.
So
I am what God says I am. Not what my friends say I am. Not what people say I am. Not what family spirits say I am. I am what God says I am. So I have to silence the devils. I have to silence all critics. The Spirit of the Lord came in the prison because Joseph was in prison. The Spirit of the Lord will come into your situation because you are in that situation. When you are in a combi, the Spirit of God can enter that combi because you are a part of God. You came from God and you go back to God. This world can never hold you. Father, our destiny is in the high places in heaven. We are seated in heavenly places. That's our adoption. Father, Joseph, when he saw Potiphar, he said, thank you, Potiphar. If your wife did not lie, I would not be here now. It was God's plan. It was the strategizing God. He went to his brothers and said, then to the man who saw me was mightily used of God.
Brothers,
in all things, we are more than conquerors. All things, even bad things, work together for the good to them that love their God. Who can move today from their pits to the throne somewhere?
But
from the Tatladosia, the Spirit says, he that overcometh shall sit with me at my throne. One day we shall leave this dark world.
God, when you suck social,
to the throne of God. Father, that time we shall overcome gravity. From the pit to the throne. In a split second, before Pharaoh called Joseph, God called him. And then he spoke through Pharaoh, who was to be an enemy of Israel. He was used to elevate
Joseph.
God can use your problems and your situations and your enemies to elevate you. It becomes the devil's own goals. Father, when
Daniel
came out of the pit of lions,
he went
straight to the throne. When
Benaiah
came out of the pit where he fought the lion, he went straight to the throne. When Christ came out of the pit of the grave, he was going to the throne. When Job came out of the airship, he was going straight to promotion. When Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out of the pit of the fire, they were going straight to promotion. When
Mordecai,
the gallows that he was going to be hanged in, he was going straight to promotion. When the four lepers came out of that place where they were rejected, they were going straight to fame. When Mephibosheth came out of Lodibar, he was going straight to the throne. The throne of God is calling. You have a place in the throne of God. You shall overcome. Let's look at things in God's eyes. Let's look at things in God's eyes. In God's eyes, brother, through this Bible, every sick person was healed 2,000 years ago. In God's eyes, brother, every poor person is rich, brother. In God's eyes, you are justified. You have not done it in the first place. You looked at your perfect picture. They are Josephs of today. It was all planned, brother. That one day you'll be discouraged. At the end of the story is victory. It was all planned. That one day you'll be rejected. But the end of the story is joy. It was all planned. That one day you have no food. But the end of the story, you will sit at a table with Christ. Is there any Joseph who is ready, who is feeling the call of God? I feel my theophany calling. Bye bye to the prisons. Bye bye to the prisoners. You see me no more there. Those were bound by demons. God is calling you. You have a place prepared for you. Those were bound by debts. Debts are being cancelled by the heavenly powers. Diseases are being cancelled by the heavenly powers. Father, what belongs to us, we are not followed by demons, but surely goodness and mercy shall follow me on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, all the days of my life. I'm not followed by court summons. I'm not followed by debts in the family, but I'm followed by goodness and mercy. Listen, brother. If you are following Jesus, you can't be followed by the devil, because he is not a follower of Christ. You can't be followed by diseases, because they are not followers of Christ. Brother, his angel is God before you. Before Joseph was in prison, the angel entered prison. Before Joseph was in the pit, the angel entered the pit. Before you were in that situation, he is a high priest that can be touched by the feelings of your infirmities. Father, I don't usually preach theology. I preach what happens that very day. I'm not here to teach you the history of the Bible, but I'm teaching what is happening now. Our God is able. Our God is able. We are defying all defiance. If God be with us, who can be against us? But from barrenness, Joseph came out of that womb that was barren. He passed through a barren womb and passed through a family of critics and passed through a deep pit and passed through prison, some through the waters, some through the floods. But God gives a song in the night season and all the day long. Brother, you start rejoicing now. Your answer comes unlocked by your shout of victory. It's the walls of Jericho fall unlocked by your shout of victory. As we stand to our feet ready to pray, we are ready to pray as the children of God. When we begin to pray, something must shake, something must happen. Where the supernatural God is, the supernatural happens. God is not confined to the picture there.
agabona kusithombe.
That pillar of fire is moving right now.
Insika yomlilo iyahamba khona manje.
He is out of the picture.
Usephumile kusithombe.
Moving among his people.
Uhamba ebantwini bakhe.
The God of the Bible.
UNkulunkulu weBhayibheli.
In present tense.
Wallace is cut.
If there is a sick person, the anointing can heal you here. Don't wait for the hands of men. God is ready to bankrupt heaven and for any of his promises. I'm reviving your faith, your testimony that was almost dying, when you were almost getting discouraged because you waited for too long for a house that we pronounced upon you that you shall receive. You waited for too long for the Holy Spirit that you said you shall receive. You have waited for too long for the courtship that we pronounced upon you. Yes, Joseph had waited for too long. But the time came. As this time has come. This is the time, my sister. Those who are afflicted. My Bible says, many are the afflictions of the righteous. But the Lord delivers them from all of them. So your afflictions, you shall start counting them as your many blessings. Name them one by one. Count your blessings. Name them one by one. It will surprise you what the Lord has done. I like those surprises. I like those surprises. Where you are surprised of what God has done. As if you didn't want it so. But you are just surprised. Like that woman with goiter. She was expecting it to go. But she was surprised. Until she started looking for the goiter. You shall be looking for your problem. I declare that it's over. It's over. Be ready to pray. Be ready to shout the victory. Whatever you are praying for, your God is able, brother. Your God is able, brother. Your God will provide. As we take our position, as we take our position, may God take his position. May angels take their position. Heaven is loaded with blessings for everyone who is here. Heaven is loaded with breakthroughs for everyone. Those who are spiritually barren, those who are financially barren, Jesus breaks every fetter. Those who are sinners, be free from your sins. There is a man here that can turn on the light. If you are in your darkest hour, oh brother, don't surrender to the devil. Surrender all to Jesus. Cast your cares on him. It's not the mathematics of the economy. It's the level of your faith. When your faith hits there, something will precipitate. Raise your faith, my brother. Raise your faith, my sister. Something is fixing to happen. The power of God is in this room right now. God is visiting his people. The power of the Holy Spirit is breaking forth. Is breaking forth, is breaking forth. God is powerful. He's bigger than your doubts, brother. He's bigger than your problems. He's bigger than any mountain that you can see. God is bigger than your situation. Invite him. Pray a prayer of faith. Call him on the scene. Call him on the scene. I'm another Joseph today. I'm receiving my blessing. That's why I'm rejoicing. Because it's first spiritual. Then it precipitates. It happens as you are praying and crying in the spirit. There is a hand that touches you. That hand specializes in things not impossible. God can touch your children. God can touch your womb and fibers disappear.
God can touch your minds and frustrations and worries and stress. God is with you in your exam room. He's with you in your marriage. He's with you in your marriage. He's with you in your ministry. He's with you when you are praying.
He
interceded with the groanings that cannot be uttered by
men.
There was a time when
Potiphar
was too small for Joseph. Was now too small for Joseph. There was a time when the brothers of Joseph were now too small for
Joseph.
Your problem is now too small for you, because greater is he. Oh brothers, spiritual services, there must be someone receiving the Holy Spirit. There must be a move of God in that church. There must be a power surge in that church. There must be a visitation in that church. May God display his attributes of healing. May it display his attributes of salvation. May it display his attributes of providing. May it display his attributes of guarding you. Oh brothers, I have a blessed assurance. Blessed assurance. This is my story. This is my song. When I'm in the mighty cave, I praise the Lord until he takes me out. Whether food or no food, I praise my Lord anyhow. Shoes or no shoes, I praise the Lord anyhow. He is able to lift you out of the mighty. You are moving, my brother. You are being promoted by the power of the Spirit of God. Our Heavenly Father.
Amen.
Mighty God, we worship you, Father. We feel the vibrations of your spirit. We feel your power moving in the house. Although unworthy we are, Lord, but because of your plan, before the foundation of the world, when you predestinated us, you saw our challenges. You saw, Father, the giants that will stand in our way. But you wrote it, that we are more than conquerors. Father, may you empower your children. May our lives be such a reflection of the life of Christ. May our life, O Lord, defy all the dark times, O Lord, that we pass through. Heavenly Father, as this anointing is moving and blanketing your children, may all sicknesses vanish. May all troubles vanish. May all deaths vanish. May you take over, Holy Spirit. Persuade the hearts of your children. Give them a revival in their hearts. Give them a revival, Lord, in their homes, in their families, in their workplace, in their hearts, O Lord. Let them shout that joy, O Lord, for knowing that he that has promised is more than able to perform. He that gave us this spoken word is more than able to create what is missing in our lives, to create what we are lacking. Oh, Father, what an assurance we have. Oh, let your children, we have struggled for too long, praying and fasting against stubborn situations of their lives, O Lord, in their homes, hard times and scars of life. Father, until their hopes was almost erased. But Father, in the darkest hour, we say, then Jesus came. And from that time, something happened. Heavenly Father, I pray for every new person who came here with a heavy burden, who came here, Lord, crippled by sin, O Lord, like Mephibosheth, crippled by previous experiences. But Heavenly Father, I believe they have a place at the temple. They have a place in your presence. Father, they are somewhere at the altar, and they are somewhere kneeling, O Father, wherever they are, O Lord, waiting for the answer from heaven. Waiting for your voice to speak into their hearts. Waiting, O Lord Father, for you to thunder forth. When they hear that voice saying it's over, when they hear that voice say, my child, rejoice. Oh Father, then the toils of the road, they become nothing. Father, when we come like this, we can't go back home the same. We can't go back home defeated. Heavenly Father, our burdens are lifted at Calvary. Father, all our stresses are lifted. May you help us to live in victory, shouting the victory, testifying victory, defying all defiance, true to your word, O Lord. Oh, Father, I know, Lord, you will make a way. I know my Lord will make a way. If I live a holy life like Joseph did, and shun the wrong and do the right, I know my Lord, he will make a way. In that pit, there is an eye watching me. In that prison, there is an eye watching me. Oh Lord, you can never forsake your children. You can never leave them alone, Lord. Oh, you promised never to leave me. Though I feel the lightning flashing and the thunder's roaring, oh, I feel a peace in knowing that the Lord is with me. Oh, great Jehovah, strong. Search your children. Revive your children. Forgive your children. Bless your children. Anoint your children. Oh, Father, fight their battles. Fight their battles. Oh, Heavenly Father, fight their battles, O Lord. We shall not need to fight this battle, but we depend on you, O Lord. I believe someone has received something. I believe someone, O Lord, yes, touch the hem of your garment. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We worship you. You are Alpha and Omega. You are everything that we need, O Lord Father. You are the lion that prevailed. You are the mighty conqueror. We are submitting our cases to you. You are the great lawyer, the great advocate, the great emancipator, the great searcher, the great I am, the great Jehovah Jireh, the great Jehovah Nissi, the great, O Lord Father, light that shines in our life. O Lord, help your children. May they receive a blessing. Those who are new, O Father, as we shall lay hands on them, may your power touch them and bless them in Jesus' name. As I call the song leader, let's rejoice in the spirit. Give us the songs of Jubilee. Goliath's head is down. The lion has roared. Who can but prophesy? As I call the new people that needs to be laid hands on, those who have visited are coming here to pray for. As we sing the songs of the redeemed, we'll pray for you, we'll lay hands on you. God bless you. Has no, my heart has no.
Me, Lord, with you, I'll pray.